Okay, so good evening again, everyone. Tonight we will discuss about poultry production. So, sinong present? Shem, Ma'am Elba, ng Mertz, Ma'am Pinky. Okay. So, guys, when we say poultry production, why poultry production is popular here in our country, and mostly our country is really embracing, no, the poultry production here, especially in Western Visayas. Sa atun area, usually we are into Philippine native chicken raising. So how come or why? Poultry production is popular because they are fast multipliers. They are prolific, no? Maraming mangitlog. And then they are also quick growers. And then, more efficient feed converters. Among all the poultry species, no, from chicken, ducks, quails, ano pa ba? Turkey, mga magaganda sila or mga efficient sila mag-convert ng feed into lean, okay, or into their meat. But among all poultry species, chicken is the most efficient converters of feed into meat. So please try to remember that chickens yung pinaka-effective na feed converters among all poultry species. And then chicken, as we are all aware of, chicken yung pinaka-popular na poultry species sa atin since it's more marketable, it's more in demand, okay? And parang we are already comfortable with its maintenance as well as production. And then second na pinaka-popular is the duck production. We have, of course, meat production ng duck, egg production ng duck for our specifically balut, penoy, salted eggs. Diba? Meron tayong balut sa puti. May isa pang balut eh. Hindi lang ako sure, pero meron din tayong mga penoy. And then, yung third na popular, yung tatlong hierarchy, is the quail, or what we call itlog ng ang pugo. Itlog ng pugo. Another one popular product sa duck eggs pala is the century eggs, yung black. Later we will discuss that. And then here is the taxonomy. Every production system that we've already discussed, now we really need to identify the taxonomy because sometimes lumalabas talaga sa board exam. So again, let's start sa pinakauna, domain, again, eukarya. And then, kingdom, animalia, phylum, chordata, class, aves. Unlike sa mga present natin na mga past production systems, usually hanggang genus and species lang yung difference. Sa avian species naman, yung order nila is divided into four. Meron tayong mga galliformes, anseriformes, columbiformes, and then struthiformes. So, yung mga sa galliformes, please try to take note, yun sila yung mga chickens. Dito included yung chickens natin, gallus, chickens, turkey, quails, and then yung mga game fowls natin. Meron silang mga V-shaped breast. Okay, tama, V-shaped lang naman ang breast nila. And then, meron silang true phallus or copulatory organ. And then, sa anseriformes naman, anser Answer, yes. Included doon yung ating goose. Answer. Included din yung ducks. Anas platyrhynchus. Included din yung ducks, merong bibe, merong itik. Okay? Da Kairina muscata natin, o yung Muscovy duck. And then yung anas platyrhynchus natin, o yung mallard duck or wild duck. Okay? Itik tsaka bibe. Included din sa anseriformes yung ating swan. Mostly sa mga anseriformes are ang mga wet fowls, I think. Yes. Wet fowls or yung mga, excuse me, mga wet. Oy, baka ano yung iniisip nyo. Wet fowl mean yung nasa tubig or pwede sa tubig. Okay? Hindi yung wet na wet. Next is our Colombiformes. Of course, our Columbia livia, included doon yung pigeons, and then doves. And then, sikat naman yung mga Colombiformes sa kanilang tinatawag na pigeon milk. Usually may secretion yan. Okay, mga doves. May secretion yan, something sa physiology nila na they provide it to their youngs. Okay? And then, Struthiformes, the very unique ostrich. Yung identifier lang naman sa Struthiformes is meron silang flat breast. Okay? That's it. So, pero yung pinaka-marketable dito sa country or yung may demand or yung may market is the Galliformes and the Anseriformes because nandito yung ating gallus and nandito yung ating ducks. Okay? So, okay ba kayo guys? Are you still there?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, here, and assignment nyo na lang yung mga scientific names. Chicken, gallus domesticus, or gallus, and then, sometimes, di ba, sa ating mga four-legged animals, I told you to really memorize the gestation period, or ilang days yung gestation, ilang months yung gestation. The same rin sa ating mga poultry species or sa avians natin. It's really important to memorize, okay, or familiarize at least their incubation period. Kahit hindi na nga yung egg weight. Kasi parang hindi na kaya. Pero kung kaya pa, edi push. Pero kung hindi na, don't mind it na lang. Baka ma-TMI or too much information. Pero yung incubation period is really important. So, I gave emphasis here sa limang species na to. Chicken, our ducks, turkey, quail, pigeon. Okay, so give priority to them. So, chicken, meron tayong 21 days, pinaka-common, and then yung mallard natin or yung itik have 28 days incubation period. And then yung Muscovy, yung bibe, merong 35 to 37 incubation period days. And then turkey natin, Meleagris gallopavo, 28. Quail, Coturnix, o yung pugo, merong 16 to 18 days. And then pigeon, Columbia livia, have 18 days. And then, please remember as well the ostrich. Pinakamalaking egg. Okay. Yung, remember guys, quail yung pinakamaliit na egg. And then, ostrich yung pinakamalaki. Hopefully, we all know that naman. And then, geese, yung incubation period, around 30 to 31 days. Swan, 35 days. Ostrich, yun na nga, yung pinakamalaki yung incubation period. Makes sense kasi siya rin yung pinakamalaking egg among all, meron siyang 42 days. And then PFAL natin, 28. Pheasant and then Guineafowl, 23 to 24 and 28 respectively. So, ganun lang naman. Just remember the incubation period and pay attention sa mga common na poultry species here in the Philippines. Give priority to them para iwas information overload. So, who's up for games? Okay, just a quick icebreaker. So, Shem, araman si Shem, no? Nandyan ba si Shem? Hello? Busy si Shem.
Shem, buwi ka pa da?
Busy si Shem. Okay, so ano na lang? Try as much as you can, if you can answer the question or fill in the blanks, okay, just type it in or just answer in chorus. Anyone is allowed to answer. Okay? Merong prize yung unang makasagot or yung overall score. Ano yung tawag sa young chicken natin? Ano?
Chicks. Mambal na ko tani. Dumlan ko tani. Sa tubig ba?
Sigyan. Sigyan yung unang sumagot. Sigyan mahilig sa chicks. Okay. Correct. Chick lang. Walang S gyan.
Nakaida mo, chicks ting yan.
Oo. And then, immature female chicken or young female chicken? Ano? Start with letter P.
Pullet.
Pullet. Very good. Sino yun? Ma'am Elba? Okay. Very good. Pullet. Yung adult female chicken natin, ano yung tawag?
Masab gakaon ko mare.
Very good gidyag yan, as in. Immature male chicken or young male chicken before sexual maturity. Ano yon?
Bilak mo oh.
Na lang siya kung na magsugid. Wala na. Wala na. Walang makahula. Yan, immature or young?
Immature. Yung immature yung rooster, yeah.
Sorry.
Cockerel, ma'am.
Correct. It's cockerel.
Cockerel.
Ay, sorry.
Yung rooster.
Alam nyo na yung rooster. Okay? Cock or rooster. Very good. Dali lang. Ah, young baby. Kunwari hindi nyo nakita. Young baby duckling.
Duckling.
Ano ba next? Adult female duck. Ano? Anong tawag? Hula lang. Go, Gyan. Start with letter D. Baka sabihin nyo Daisy, ha?
Bulak ka, girl.
D.
Daisy Duck.
Dinosaur yung naisip ko.
Ronald Duck.
Okay, hear it. So, yung female, adult female duck is also called duck or simply hen rin.
Okay.
So, pinapa-confuse ko lang kayo ng very, very light. Ay, hindi, immature female chicken. Ano to? Adult male duck. Ano ba yan? Di na-edit.
Adult male duck.
Oh, ano? Anong-ano? Tuloy. Ano yung answer? Ano to siya? Singer. Rapper. Hindi nyo alam?
Shanty Dope.
Chris Brown. Start with letter D. Ano? Skustakli. Start with letter D. Ano?
Daddy yo.
Wala. Walang wakakahula.
What? Next letter.
Next.
Next letter.
Here.
Drake?
Oh, Drake. Correct. Young baby turkey. Di. Yung makakahula may 20 pesos. Wala. Wala na.
Baby shark.
Okay, hear it. It's called poult.
Okay.
Okay. And then, yung young female turkey naman is called Jenny. Okay? Si Jenny, si Lisa, si Jisoo, tsaka si Rose. Joke lang. Yung adult female turkey naman is tinatawag na hen. Ganun din, general term. Young male turkey is called Jake. Okay? Zyrus, char. Yung partner ni Jenny is si Jake. And then adult male turkey, usually this is common, no? May mga questions talaga na nagre-refer sa adult male turkey, or minsan yung term na ginagamit nila is tom. This can be a cat, actually tom, lalaking cat is tom rin. Pero in poultry naman, tawag kay turkey is tom or gobbler. So please try to remember that. Because may na-encounter ako na question na parang naka-mention ng gobbler. Okay? So, that's it. Try, ito lang naman yung mga common. So, if you want, you can also include here, nasa review material naman, yung sa swan, yung sa goose. Okay? Meron din doon. Male, female, young, immature, mature. Okay? And then, this one, this is a turkey. Actually, distinct sa turkey, sa physical appearance niya, or sa external anatomy niya, presence ng caruncle, snood, and then wattle. So, yung caruncle, actually, this can also be seen sa ating ducks. Meron din sa ating, yeah, sa ducks. Meron din sa chicken. Brightly colored growths on the throat region turns bright red when a tom or yung lalaking turkey is upset or during courtship activities. Wait. And then yung snood, a flap of skin that hangs over the turkey's beak. Snood. So tandaan nyo, yung caruncle is namumula-mula if nangliligaw or if disappointed, si male turkey. Kayo rin ba guys, yung mga male dyan or yung mga lalaki dyan, if disappointed kayo or if nangliligaw kayo, namumula-mula din ba? It turns to bright.
Yung ano?
It turns to bright red din ba?
Yung tega.
Ano, flattered?
Yeah, flattered. Yung ano nyo?
Ang blangga blush.
Yung ears malaki nyo.
Banaga pala mula ng talinga nila.
Oh, okay. Okay. Akala ko may
ang yung ano. Ang malaki na yung ano.
Oo. That's why nga kinoconfirm ko sa mga boys here na present, if nangliligaw sila or if disappointed sila sa mga partners nila or sa mga girlfriends nila, if namumula-mula, is that correct? Or?
Yeah.
Ay, blood na?
Like turn into bright red. Gian, hindi ka naman namumula sa high blood. Nangingitim ka nun.
Oo, kasi black na yung ano, yung tugo mo.
Papunta ka ng deads nun if pina-high blood ka. Okay. Flap of, yung snood nga again is a flap of skin na nag-hang under lang ng beak. Okay? And then yung wattle, as we all know, it's a flap of skin under here. Sa chicken, meron din ito. And then, the same. It turns also bright red when the turkey is upset or during courtship. So, possible talaga na mag-turn red din siya because it's an extension rin ng ating ng kanyang caruncles. Ano? I don't know actually the specific or the scientific explanation of that. Siguro hormones, you know. If hormones na sometimes hindi na mapipigilan. Yung snood rin as well, meron ding times na nagre-red. The same scenario. So, that's it for tonight, Char. Joke lang. Classes based on utilization. When we say utilization, the other term for this is, of course, yung usage niya. Sa poultry natin, meron tayong five utilization or five uses among our poultry species. Of course, the most important one, the egg utilization and of course the meat utilization. Sa mga egg class natin, included doon yung leghorn, minorca, ancona, mikawa. So, yung mga egg class, mga smaller sizes sila, okay? Pero prolific layer sila and they are usually very active. When we say prolific layers, maraming mangitlog. Ganun lang. And then, sa meat class, on the other hand naman, very different from the egg class, yung meat class is usually larger. Okay? Mga large sizes or mga larger breeds dito sa meat class and sa egg class, smaller breeds. If you can see the association, di ba, if both in mammals and in avians, no? If they are approaching oviposition na, or parturition or breeding, we don't want them to get too fat. So, that's also the reason or that's also the association na bakit yung mga smaller breeds is nasa under ng egg class. Obviously, yung mga meat class, gusto natin larger sila because that's their main point. Dapat mas malalaki para mas malaki rin yung ma-harvest na meat. Okay? Larger sizes yung nasa meat class and then usually fast grower sila. Mas mabilis sila lumaki. And then, usually sa mga meat class na breeds, which is Brahma, Cochin, Langshan, Cornish, usually mga sluggish and docile sila. Or yung mga tamad. Hindi sila very active unlike ng egg class. So, ganun. Tamad silang gumalaw-galaw. Dual purpose versus a char. Yung pwedeng maging egg, pwede ring maging meat. They can provide good meat yield as well as, they can lay adequate amount of eggs. That's the dual purpose. Included dyan, mga New Hampshire natin, Rhode Island Red, and your Plymouth Rock, Barred Plymouth Rock. Fancy class, ito majorly na utilization for fancy class is for aesthetic purposes. Okay? Ano yung aesthetic purposes? We want to have them because of their appearance. It may be pwedeng gawing pet, okay? Or pwedeng pang show. Fighting class naman, yung mga specific bloodlines na dine-develop specifically for game fowl sports, okay? Game fowl. Or, pwede kang mag-alaga ng fighting class na breed if hindi ka kayang ipaglaban ng mahal mo. Manok na lang ipaglaban para sa'yo. Okay, that's it. The word self-explanatory naman. So, here, an example. Wait. Barred plymouth rock. Sometimes, ginagamit din for eggs, ginagamit din for meat. Okay? Barred siya, tinatawag siya na barred because yung stripe-stripe na ganito is tinatawag na barring. I think na-mention ko to sa genetics. Okay? That's why naging barred. Usually, brown yung egg niya and then, ganun. Brown eggs. Yun lang yung mga dapat tandaan. Brown eggs. And then, Rhode Island Red. Yung brown din yung eggs niya. Utilization niya mostly for eggs din. And then, of course, the famous white leghorn. Very common here. Utilization niya for eggs. If you can observe, guys, if nakikita nyo here in the Philippines, we have nung mga bata pa tayo, or even until now, sa mga agri-vet, no? Or sa mga fiesta-fiesta, meron kang makikitang pink na chicks, yellow na chicks, na sometimes we're very fascinated na bilhin. Okay? Yung sa mga tindahan, or sa mga market, nakikita nyo ba yan? Nakikita nyo ba
sa
yan?
Sa labas ng school.
Correct! Sa labas ng school. Buti na lang hindi tayo classmate. Sa labas ng school namin, walang nagtitinda ng ano, ng live chicks. Tinitinda sa labas ng school namin yung day old chick na inihaw na. Hindi yung live chicks. Pero sometimes meron din yung mga very cute chicks sa mga tindahan, sa mga market or sa mga agri-vet na mga stores, usually yung ginagamit nila is chicks ng white leghorn. Why? Because yun sila yung mga culled or hindi sinelect na mga chicks because they are male. Usually, if bumili ka ng sisiyo and then if pinalaki mo, magiging ganito yung itsura niya. Okay? Sa mga tinda-tindahan, ganito yon. Kasi yun yung mostly mga chicks na white leghorn na lalaki. And as we all know, we don't need a much of male white leghorn since white leghorn is very famous for egg production. So, hindi sila magagamit if layer farm, for example, and then merong lalaking chicks. Okay? So, make sense? Yes.
Noted.
Okay, so sometimes, hindi ba kayo nag-curious why iba't-ibang kulay yung itlog? Diba? Merong brown, sometimes merong black, merong pale, merong peach, merong maputi. Itlog. I remember so many people. Joke. Okay, so why do you think the reason? What do you think the reason is? I'm sorry. Bakit merong different colors ng eggs? Why? Is this, what do you think? Is this environment? Is this genetics? Or is this just because ganun lang siya talaga? Ano? Any idea?
Pwede maka-volunteer?
Yes, yes. Anyone?
Parang tao lang yan. Parang isipin mo lang, lahat tayo may identity sa lahat ng bagay. Yung itlog, puti, may brown. Tao, itim, puti, brown. O, ganito lang. Pero sa loob, the same naman eh. May yolk naman may puti. That's why sa akin, parang identity na lang po.
Very good.
Okay na po.
Okay na yan. Ano ba kulay ng itlog mo? Diyan, sa pututan, di ba may manok kayo? native nyo, white. Dito kasi sa amin, brown usually. Yung hindi naman super brown, pero hindi siya very pure white yung color, especially if native, no? Going into dirty white. So, the reason why, pero thank you sa answer, gano. Tandaan nyo nga, iba't iba yung sa tao, iba't iba yung kulay ng itlog. The same din sa chicken. Okay, yung different eggshells natin, or yung different colors ng eggshells natin is dependent sa kung anong breed yan siya. Okay? Because, let's say, for example, yung, here, barred rock. Lahat ng mga barred rock or barred plymouth rock is magiging ganito yung kulay ng eggs. Because they have the specific gene na mag-i-indicate, okay, or presence ng specific pigment na mag-i-indicate or mag-i-influence sa pagiging brown ng eggshell. Okay? So, let's not go deeper na sa mga kung anong protein yan or sa kung anong gene number yan because I think it's not that important pagdating ng board exam. Pero ganun, may specific gene yan or may specific protein present on that specific breed na mag-i-influence sa color ng eggshell niya. So, it's not most likely more on genetic siya. It's not 100% environment yung influence ng color ng eggshells. Ganon. Meron ngang eggshells na color blue. Ganon. Because merong mataas yung believer din nila. Okay? Meron din eggshell na black. So, depende sa gene. Okay. So, sa meat utilization naman, sikat yung Black Jersey Giant. So, bakit sa Jersey kung wala naman siyang Jersey? Joke. This is mostly color black. Exotic. It's an American breed. Okay. American. So, Americano siya. And then, Jersey siya because kahit hindi siya basketball player, this specific breed is from New Jersey. Okay? Sa America. And one of the largest breeds and heaviest among all chickens. Okay? Largest and heaviest. Among all chickens, heaviest. Please try to remember that. It's for meat utilization, obviously, kasi malaki siya. Next is ayam simani. So, this is very expensive. Expensive breed siya, okay? Originally from Indonesia. If you can see naman, all black. Even the comb and the wattle, that's how the ayam simani is really designed, no? It's actually a native chicken in India. In Indonesia, pero marami na siyang modifications or na-select na siya. Binibreed nila sa doon yung very black, pure black usually, yung genetic niya or yung modification niya is pinag-aralan na, okay? Or controlled na. And then, tinatawag lang, may mga hyperpigmentation lang sila. Most probably because mataas yung melanin sa body nila. That's why black. And tinatawag din siyang Rolls Royce among all chicken. Because nga, expensive. Rolls Royce. Ganda, no? Australorp from Australia and then dual type. Common lang. Next, Onagadori. Onagadori. Sino mahilig sa anime? Usually, meron to, Onagadori. This is a historic Japanese breed. Okay, Japan. characterized by its very, 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 very long and exceptional tail. So fancy, again, fancy is for aesthetic and pet or show. Pwede siyang gawing pet, pwede rin siyang gawing for show. And then, usually, humuhupa siya sa mga matataas so that ma-showcase yung long tail niya. Or nakadapo siya sa matataas. From Japan. Ganda, no? Next. Cookin Bantam. Fancy as well. Okay, for palaging ginagawang pet. It's very popular yung bantam. For aesthetics. Pet or show again. Ang ganda ng feather. Ito, frizzled bantam. Na-discuss ko rin to sa genetics and animal breeding part. Usually yung frizzled, there's a specific gene na nagpapa-embed ng pagiging frizzled feather ng chicken na to. Parang ano lang, bagong gising na hindi nakapagsuklay. Something like that. For fancy purposes din siya. And again, if you could still remember, frizzled gene sa chicken na to, co-exhibit slow metabolism, and I think it has something to do with their digestion as well. So yung mga frizzled, usually known sila na mahihina in terms sa metabolism. And then, we have our silky. So this chicken is a half shih tzu, half chicken. Do you agree? Half shih tzu. Very cute, no? So, yung shih tzu, I think 5,000 pesos, no? Pero yung silky here in the Philippines, mabibili mo lang to 2,500. So, pili ka, shih tzu na 5,000 o silky na 2,500. What do you think? Ako sa silky na lang ako. And then, yung silky breed. Yung silky breed natin is from China. Ganda. Chinese breed. It's a Chinese breed. It's a Chinese breed. And then, marami ng silky. Actually, marami ng silky na nag-aalaga here in the Philippines. Usually, sa mga zoo, makikita na to. And yung sa mga nag-show ng chicken, yung mga chicken fashion shows, meron ng mga silky. Common na to here. It's an international breed already. And then, usually, pag kinatay yung silky, yung laman niya is color black. Again, the reason why may mga black meat tayo or black feathers is again the presence lang ng melanin. Okay? Fancy or meat. Kinakain din siya. Isipin mo, no? Katayin mo yung silky. Akala mo silky, shih tzu pala. Naging asusena. And then, dragon chicken. So this is endemic in Vietnam. In Vietnam. Endemic means doon nag-originate. Okay? Doon makikita. It's called the dragon chicken. Or their local name for that chicken is Dong Tao. Bakit dragon chicken? Very obvious. Parang dragon daw yung legs. Okay.
Sa makaon.
Yes, actually.
Dragon kapun sa may silky.
Yes, actually.
Yaman ka kohog ba? Unit-unit.
Oy, wait. Actually, yung dragon chicken or yung dongchao, okay, dongchao na breed is served sa mga royal family. And do you know what specifically yung habol? Ay, hindi to binibreed for commercial purposes, ha? Binibreed lang sila for royal family exclusively sa Vietnam. And specifically, the meat that is served sa mga royal family is their legs. Sa Vietnam, delicacy sa mga royal family yung legs ng dragon chicken. So, that's a trivia. Actually, ay nako, imagine. Eh, di ko kaya. Di ko kaya.
Kaya mo yan. Laking fried chicken yan.
If tinitingnan ko yung legs niya, iba yung naaalala ko. So, hindi ko kaya kainin, just in case.
Do malaria ba?
hindi ko nga kaya yung Adidas na tinitinda dito. Tapos ganito pa, no?
Damo collagen ba?
It's kasing laki ito ng isang arm. Arm
sure.
Ni, yes, arm ni Heidelin Diaz. Pero seryoso ho. Oo. For fancy and for meat. Mostly meat.
Because
isang delicacy siya. Okay. And as well, this is very expensive. So among all those international breeds and exotic breeds, of course, we have our very own Philippine native chicken. So mga Philippine native chicken fans diyan. Okay, we have different groups ng Philippine native chicken. First, of course, the very common here in our place is the darag.
Darag.
This is arguably to be the most popular native chicken breed sa mga backyard raisers here in the Philippines. Okay, so darag usually can be found specifically in Panay Island, Iloilo, Negros, Guimaras as well. Common yung darag. And then, prominent sa kanila, yung medyo yellow yung plumage. Okay, may yellow part. And then, sa lalaki naman, merong shiny red na plumage. And itim yung tail. And yung shank nila or yung paa-part nila is medyo gray. Okay? Darag naman is very known sa kanilang unique flavor and meat texture. So, when we talk about meat, may advantage si darag. Yun na lang yung tandaan nyo. And then, si darag din yung pinaka-famous or pinaka-mas ginagamit na alternative for commercial production. Si darag yon. Next one is si banaba. Banaba is an indigenous chicken na makikita sa... Saan? Sino makakahula? Baden ba?
Kawan, Mindoro. Joke.
Bangladesh.
Hindi.
Ba.
Batangas.
Batangas. Correct. Sa Batangas area and sa Quezon province area, doon maraming banaba. Doon yun nag-originate or doon yun nag-start. Straight comb lang. Wala namang ibang ano. Red, orange. And then, that's it. So, isa lang yung Philippine native chicken, guys, ha? Pero, nag-evolve na sila, depende sa lugar. Yung phenotypic or yung genetic group each lugar is also showing a unique characteristic. Depende sa lugar niya. Pero they are all Philippine native chicken. The same rin sa swine as what we have discussed last time. Bulinaw is common in where? Pangasinan. Pangasinan. Actually, kung hindi ka talaga animal breeding major or hindi ka animal science major, usually, lahat ng mga Philippine native chicken, feeling mo, magkakaitsura lang. Pero, yung mga animal breeders natin, especially yung nagme-major sa genetics, may mga stratification when it comes to their plumage, sa comb orientation, sa egg quality. That's why they would be able to differentiate one group from another. So that's it. So Pangasinan naman, usually yung bulinaw, yung male or roosters nila is common sa cockfighting. Poruacan, this is sa famous na where?
Palawan.
Correct. Palawan.
Kung sa'yo, sa taga Palawan, nalipat ko ba?
Yes, Palawan. Same rin sa Palawan, yung Parawakan males or roosters usually ginagamit din as sa cockfighting or sa bungeros. Tawag na sa kanila sa bungeros. Hindi sa may-ari ha, talagang sa ano, sa specific group na to, Parawakan, ginagamit for cockfighting. Next is our Camarines. So, feeling nyo, saan nag-group yung Camarines?
Sure, sa north, kung sa sore, kung sa may, ano, Camarines, sir, Camarines north, eh.
Diyos ko, dahi, may magkamali pa dito, hay nako.
Hindi ko sure, galing sa norte, sa sore.
Sa Camarines, obviously. And then, ang Huluano, saan ba yung Huluano?
Sulo.
Ha?
Sulo.
Mindanao part.
Safe ba? Tawa, sa Hulo, Sulo. Correct na to. I think, Huluano is considered among Philippine native chicken yung advantage naman when it comes sa posture, and I think one of the largest or heaviest among Philippine native chickens yung Huluano. Okay? And then yung Camarines, of course Camarines Bicol, wala naman. And then yung Camarines pala, they also exhibit some of the Plymouth Rock color. Kita nyo barred? Na-remember yung color ng barred Plymouth Rock? Yung gray na may stripes, Camarines. Okay. Next, yung mga common breeds sa ating ducks. Of course, yung pinakasikat, Biscus Tuckley, ikaw pa rin ang, ano, bibi ko. Ikaw pa rin ang bibi ko. Okay. So, one distinct characteristic ng ating Muscovy duck o Carina moscata is the presence of caruncles. Okay? Especially, this is very prominent among males na Muscovy duck. Kasi yung itik pateros natin or yung mallard, walang caruncles. Okay? And of course, the color na may black siya, and usually ang Muscovy is for meat utilization. And usually sa mga bibe natin is mas malalaki, and sometimes nga nakakatakot ng hahabol. Bibe or Muscovy duck. So, since yung scientific name ni Kairina ni Muscovy duck is Kairina moscata, yung clue word ko dito actually nung nung nag-aaral ako is ano ba? M. My M siya sa scientific name, that's why for meat siya. Kasi always dati, nako-confuse ako between Anas Platerinkus and kay Rina Muscata. So ito naman, yung Philippine mallard. Majorly or generally, yung Philippine mallard natin is for eggs. Pero meron kasing mga mallard groups na dinevelop specifically na for meat. Okay? Ito yung known na itik patero sa atin. Itik pateros. So, if meron sa choices na itik pateros, simply, yung ibig sabihin niyan is Philippine mallard. Okay? And usually puti, walang caruncles, and they're very good and prolific in laying eggs. Okay? Itik pateros. Here, we have the Itik Pinas project. So, ano ba yung Itik Pinas? Itik Pinas is a true-to-type Philippine mallard project ng BAI, okay, and DOSTP card. So, if Angel Lambio, if you have studied animal sciences research, no, or yung thesis nyo is in animal science, usually you'll encounter Dr. Lambio, or malamang sa malamang is na review of related lit nyo na si Dr. Lambio. Si Dr. Lambio is yung nanguna sa Itik Pinas project na funded by Picard, which is yung goal nila is to develop yung breeding system ni Itik Pateros or ni Philippine Mallard. Kasi yung Philippine Mallard natin dati, actually up until now, yung mga Philippine Mallard lang na rinirace backyard, wala siyang systemic breeding or hindi siya subject for selection. Pero nung nagkaroon ng Itik Pinas project, because yung mga breeders natin, duck breeders natin, they have observed na yung Philippine mallard breeds and production natin is nagde-decline. Okay? So yung mga eggs ni Itik Pateros or ni Philippine mallard, sometimes nagde-degrade na yung quality, hindi na marami mangitlog, even yung size nila hindi lumalaki. Yun. Because of that gap, pinanganak si Itik Pinas Project. Si Itik Pinas Project, of course, funded by the government, is distributed na sa Philippines, have partnered in a different universities, farm breeders ng ducks. Dito sa atin sa West Visayas State, or so we've so I think they are already participating in the Itik Pinas project where they use Philippine mallards, okay, to be developed into different groups na may include sa IP Itim, IP Kaki, and then IP Kayumanggi. Yung mga products or yung naging resulta ng Itik Pinas project na ito is from the declining performance of the Philippine mallard, eventually, because of this project, medyo umangat na. So, yung declining, napa-incline nila, mas napaganda yung quality ng eggs, yung quantity ng eggs, something like that. But it's still Itik Pateros or it's still mallard. Okay? It's just that na yung mga mallard na included sa Itik Pinas project na ito is merong systematic breeding. And yung mga Philippine mallard dati is walang systematic breeding. So, that's one important project under BAI and under Picard. Okay? And then, Pekin. Okay, we always encounter this specific breed. So, Ito naman si Pekin, kaitsura niya lang si mallard because this is also a mallard duck. So, hindi to siya native here. Okay, si mallard naman, mallard duck na Pekin is from USA. And specifically, si Pekin duck is developed for meat production. Okay? Anas Platerinkus din yung scientific name ni Pekin duck. Anas Platerinkus. So, that's it. My question about breeds?
None, ma'am. Noted.
Okay. Well, best in participation, Didya Sigyan. Okay, next. Ilang beses natin na-mention yung breed, variety, strain, okay, during our past discussions from the start. So, just to differentiate the difference, okay? So, breed possesses certain conformation or shape of body that distinguishes them from other chickens. Okay? And then, yung ating, sa loob ng breed, meron pang variety. Have the same color, plumage color, and then type of comb. And then, within kay variety, meron namang strain. A group of chickens within a variety of a breed which has undergone constant specific selection. Meron ng selection. For example, kanina, meron na tayong itik pinas kayo manggi, mga strain na yun sila. Okay? Kayo manggi. Itik pinas itim, itik pinas, ano pa ngayong isa? Ganern. So, itik pinas kayo manggi, itik pinas kaki, and then kayo manggi. Mga strain na yun sila. And then, selection for certain traits by a specified breeder for the periods of about 5 to 8 years. So, they have deeper studies na to have a strain. So, the chicken. Originally, or the animal breeders or the scientists used to believe na yung ating modern chickens right now came from a possible ancestor na tinatawag nating red jungle fowl. Okay? Ito yung itsura niya. From India. So, actually, merong question sa reviewer na where saan nag-originate yung chicken or saan or sino or anong breed yung possible na ancestor ng chicken. Usually, the answer is red jungle fowl. Okay? Kasi meron, may iba't ibang mamaya. Wait lang. Development of modern breed. So, yung ating wild jungle fowl dati, usually yung weight nila is nasa 0.9 kg lang. And that only lays a few eggs. On the other hand naman, yung ating mga modern hens can go up to 1.5 to 2.0 kg. Mga modern breeds na natin. And then, at 6 weeks of age, and lays as many as 320 eggs a year. Meron ng 1.5 to 2.0 kg sa 6 weeks ng edad ng isang manok ngayon. And then, makakalay na siya ng 320 eggs a year. Okay? So, aside from the red jungle fowl, no, meron pa yung ibang contributor in terms naman sa ating mga modern chickens. We have the Gallus Lafayette, okay? The Gallus Sonerati, and then the Gallus Varius. To be specific, the specific ancestor of chicken or Gallus right now is unknown, no? But the nearest one that they can search is actually the red jungle fowl. Yung tatlo na to are contributors na. Diba? Ang ganda. Very aesthetic and pleasing sa eyes yung mga dating breeds or dating species. So, ano nangyari? What brought the change? From the jungle fowl, paano napunta sa modern hens natin or sa modern chickens natin? So, isa lang yung sagot dyan. Dati, yung mga chickens natin, less productive. We want them to be more productive. Okay? So, hindi pwedeng puro ganda lang. Dapat productive. Okay? So, what brought the change? Scientifically, of course, genetic mutation. We all know it's just a sudden change in genes. Meron lang mutation, mag-iba yung color, iba yung order, yung gene sequence. Yon, more on genetics. Selection. So, selection, again, pwedeng natural selection and artificial selection. We've discussed this already sa breeding. So, when we say natural selection, of course, the survival of the fittest. Merong climatic differences, magsusurvive yung resistance sa stress, magsusurvive yung merong food. Yun, natural selection. Artificial selection naman is the interference na ng human beings. Okay? So, bakit nag-i-interfere si human beings? Because again, we want to achieve a certain goal for that specific breed, okay? For that specific species. For example, sa chicken, dati less productive, gusto natin i-more productive. That's why we select kung ano yung pwedeng i-crossbreed, we select yung anong maganda for meat production, we select for anong maganda sa egg production. Or if cockfighting, we select the more good composure for cockfighting. Mga ganon. May mga consideration. And then crossbreeding. Of course, crossbreeding, dahil nagko-cross and nagmi-mix yung different breeds, subject to change yung appearance nila. The same, genotypic and phenotypic composition nila. It's really subject to change because may crossing over. So, that brought the changes among our galliformes order among chickens. Ganon. Meron question? Wala. So, let's proceed to the practical side of poultry production. In poultry production, meron tayong breeding, egg farm, tsaka broiler farm. So, itong three na to, yung pinaka-major areas in our poultry business. So, depende kung anong gusto ng farmer, kung saan siya sasali or saan siya magpa-participate, let's say. So, may specialization yan. Sa breeding farm, okay, before I proceed, can I ask for a 5-minute break? 5-minute break lang.
Sige, ma'am.
CR break.
Wait.
Okay, hello guys. Kaya pa?
Kakayahan na yan.
Welcome back, ma'am.
Thank you. Tani, nag-upod ka gyan. Okay, going back. On a practical note na no, in terms of our poultry production, we have our breeding farm again, egg farm, and then broiler farm. Okay, good. So, sa broiler farm natin, sa breeding farm pala, I'm sorry. Sa breeding farm, it is where our researching or discovering of the best combination of genes or parental lines are being chosen. Okay? So, usually yung mga breeders natin, is again, I will keep on saying this, yung mga breeder stocks natin, usually sila yung mga best. Okay? Dapat walang hindi naman walang flaw, pero as much as possible, hindi masyadong distinct or prominent yung mga flaws or mga negative traits sa ating mga breeder stocks. So there is no true commercial poultry breeding farm here in the Philippines. Usually poultry breeding farms in the country are multiplier farms na galing from abroad pa, yung mga international breeders natin, or either from the government. Okay? Yan yung breeding farm practice. Usually, Picard natin, DOST, UPLB, Bureau of Animal, and then yung Bureau for Animal Breeding natin. So, breeding farms. Next is yung egg farm for egg production. This is an older scheme of poultry production engaged in many research. Okay, so merong two phases yung egg production natin. Meron tayong strictly raise for raising ng pullets. Okay, and then pangalawa yung layers per se when they are on laying na. So, isa, magre-raise ng pullets na possible maging layers. And pangalawa, yung mga nagle-lay na talaga or yung mga layers na. Okay? So, broiler farm, ito, very common. The most recent specialized field in the Philippines, stock use are broiler type chicks or chickens. Okay? For meat. Broiler for meat. And then, yung mga broiler farm natin, usually, they are contract growers, no? Let's say, contract growers ng mga malalaking company, like, let's say, San Miguel or Bounty. Usually, naghahanap sila. Magnolia, correct. Usually, naghahanap sila ng mga contract growers, no? Or mga raisers na para bigyan lang nila ng inputs yung mga contract growers na yung bahala sa labor and then sa housing. In order, that's a very good actually practice or farm system here in the Philippines because it's a win-win situation. In order for the bigger companies to reach their goal per week, let's say, or per month na supply, of course, they also need the help of the raisers. It's as well advantage naman sa mga raisers because it's a sure market. It's a surefire market na. So, wala na silang problemahin, labor na lang tsaka housing. That's it. Pero, on a practical note, sabi naman ng iba, yung pagiging contract grower or pagiging contract raiser will only improve the company but will not improve or will not expand the contract raiser itself or himself. So, I don't know. Sabi lang ng iba. But, yeah. Actually. So, culling. Culling is a big part sa ating poultry production. So, process of separating unwanted individuals in the herd. And then, for example, yung mga breeders natin, malalaman natin na pwede na silang ikal or dapat na silang ikal if may sakit. Especially sa breeders, no, when choosing breeder stocks, we are very critical or crucial. If too fat sila, because the fatness will contribute to the difficulty in laying eggs, poor growth, low egg production, small leg, poor quality, and then nagmo-molt na sila. Heavy molting, poor quality. Nagsa-start na mag-decline yung mga traits nila. That's the time when you call out. So, meron tayong phases ng poultry management. Of course, we are all aware na magsa-start tayo sa brooding, okay? Sa 0 to 6 weeks, and then growing 6 to 16 weeks, and then laying. So, first, sa brooding. This is upon hatching, okay? The moment na bumuka yung itlog and maging sisiyo, that's the start of your brooding. And that's the start na kailangan mo nang i-manage yung brooding. So, growth and development, ito yung factor na kailangan mong i-pay attention during the brooding stage. Okay? So, it's important to maximize the growth and development of the chicks in this stage. So, focus on growth and development. Sa growing naman, on this stage or on this phase, maintenance is very important. 6 to 16 weeks, phase of controlled growth, preparation for laying. So, yung mga growers, okay, yung mga growers na pre-prepare mo for laying, or yung mga growers na pinaprepare mo for breeding, dapat i-control yung growth nila. Okay? Why? Because if hindi natin i-control yung growth nila, usually, if hindi natin makontrol yung growth or hindi natin makontrol yung feeding, mag-i-accelerate niya yung sexual maturity ng isang chicken or let's say hen. Okay? So, hindi natin gusto na at a young age mag-accelerate yung sexual maturity niya because that would cause low number of eggs. Number one, because hindi natin gustong mahirapan yung chicken or yung hen. And then, low yung production ng egg because hindi pa ready yung reproductive tract niya. Okay? So, pero if yung grower natin is not for breeding and not for laying, yung grower natin is for broiler, then it's good. Okay? It's good na yung growth niya is mag-excess. Okay? Because for meat siya. And hindi natin kailangan i-control yung growth ng mga growers for meat type or for broiler. Okay? Nagko-control lang tayo ng feeding and nagko-control lang tayo ng growth sa mga growers na going layers or going breeders. Okay? And then, laying, of course, this, yung phase na to is naka-focus sa egg production. Excuse me. Naka-focus sa egg production and not sa body weight increase. Okay? Yung breeders natin, dito yung broilers natin hanggang ditong stage lang. Pag-abot niya ng 16 to 24 weeks, no matter if ma-reach na yung market weight, pwede nang i-dispose. Okay? Sa growing stage. So, laying, still working or still good up to 78 weeks. 24 to 78 weeks. Next, here is our brooding management practices. So, mainly, again, sa brooding management, yung focus natin is yung care for our chicks or sa bagong hatch na mga chicks up until 4 weeks old or 6 weeks old. So, this is an example of a brooder. Okay, brooder guard, brooding guard yung tawag dito. Okay, so ang brooding guard natin is pwedeng maging tela, pwedeng maging GI sheet, pwede yung trapal, anything na pwede bug protect sa mga chicks, basta hindi lang makalabas o baka maka-jump yung chicks over. And then we have our as well brooder lamp. Okay, this will help the chicks na hindi malamigan. Okay, magpapainit sa kanilang mga malalamig na gabi. And then litter, bed natin, very important, pwedeng maging dyaryo, pwedeng maging rice hull, pwede ring, what, sodas? Pwede rin ba yun? And then yung cage brooder natin, pwedeng nasa floor, okay? Or pwedeng nasa slat, pwedeng sa floor na nasa baba, or pwede ring sa slatted, gaya ng ganito. I think sodas yung gamit nila dito. And then, here, another example, or another type ng brooders, ng brooder is yung battery brooder natin. Kanina is, I think, our cage type brooder. Battery brooder natin is nakaganito. Sa CPU, I think, pinapractice nila to. Diba? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up to 5 elevations, divisions. Nandyan yung chicks. And then, meron rin yung water trough, and then meron ding feed trough. Ganon. Battery brooder and then cage brooder. Dalawang types ng brooder natin. So, sa brooding management natin, yung light, kailangan 24 hours. Especially yung mga young chicks natin, mga day old, up to 4 months old, very vulnerable pa sa lamig. Okay? Yung house temperature needs to be at 31 to 32 degrees Celsius at the first week. And then, you can reduce by 2 degrees pababa as they age, okay? Per week, as they age per week. 2 degrees per week, pababa ng pababa hanggang 4th week, okay? And then sa feeds, of course, after arrival, meaning after hatching or after ng hatchery, feeds, booster feeds after arrival for 1 week. And then, gradually rin, nagsishift yung feeding ration niya after 1 week from booster, papunta na sa starter. And again, we don't really suggest changing the feeds abruptly. It needs to be gradually to avoid scouring or diarrhea. And then floor space natin, 100 chicks per square meter. And then in one practice rin sa brooding management is we practice beak trimming. So beak trimming pala is a partial removal of the beak of poultry to prevent feather pecking and cannibalism. Okay? Hindi kinukuha yung beak totally, ha? Beak trimming to, hindi debeaking. So, when we say debeaking, kinukuha lahat yung beak. But when we say beak trimming, tinitrim lang. Kinukuha lang yung matulis na part. Okay? So that it will prevent them to peck with each other or to avoid cannibalism. But usually, cannibalism is just a result ng kulang sa feed ration or may specific nutrient na kulang lang sa feed ration. So, that's it. Big claiming. Here, cannibalism. What's cannibalism? It's a bad habit developed by some growing birds. It usually starts from feather or toe picking, and it may result in serious wounding and death. Or sometimes, meron ng wound. Mas gusto pa talaga ng ibang chickens yun na i-pick. The possible causes of cannibalism are, yes, correct imbalance ration. A high energy diet with low protein leads to this problem. Yan, if kulang yung protein, usually merong cannibalism. And then overcrowding and insufficiency of feeding and drinking spaces. Okay? And then marami sila pero hindi sila magkakasya sa feeding, sa feed trough or sa ating mga water trough. And then extended period without feed and water, poor ventilation, excessive heat, and may also be a strain characteristics. Ugali niya lang talaga na maging cannibalistic. Okay? So ganon. Meron kasing mga specific breeds na talagang nag-exhibit ng cannibalistic characteristic or ng cannibalistic trait. So hindi maiiwasan 'yon, especially yung mga aggressive breeds. So another, ano ba yung mga nag-a-affect sa length ng brooding period natin? So first is the weather and the climatic condition. Longer yung brooding period during cold and rainy months. And then shorter during dry or warm months. Okay. And then longer yung brooding period if malamig. And then shorter rin yung brooding period if mainit. That's correct. Okay. Of course, if malamig, we need to have an artificial heat. It's always rainy, malamig. Ayaw ng mga chicks yun. They will make that specific cold, or if rainy season, the chicks are very vulnerable sa sakit. Very high yung mortality, especially if rainy season, no? Pero, of course, if during dry months and warm season, hindi na natin kailangan maglagay ng high artificial heat because it's already heat sa surroundings, okay? At hindi rin sila vulnerable sa sakit. And especially guys, if rainy months, mataas yung moisture, and as what you have, I don't know if you've already discussed this, pero if mataas yung moisture, meaning mataas din yung possibility ng existence ng ating viruses, existence ng ating mga bacteria, and other harmful microorganisms, okay? If mataas yung moisture. And then, yung rate of feathering natin. So, shorter for fast feathering can be due to genetic makeup or nutrition of birds. Ano ba yung feathering? Ano ba yung feathering? So, feathering, ito po yung transition ni... Wait. Rate of feathering. Ano ba yung feathering? Ito yung transition ni down feather si down feather or yung balahibo ng sisiyo papunta na sa actual na balahibo ng manok. Okay? So, meron tayong mga breeds na tinatawag na fast featherers. Okay? Meron mga breeds na tinatawag na fast featherers. Sino sila? Of course, yung mga fast featherers. Yung mga breeds na fast featherers, yun yung mga breeds na nag-exhibit ng trait na mabilis mag-transit yung kanilang down feather or yung mga sisiw feathers nila papunta sa actual na feathers na ng mature na manok. So, ganun lang. Down feather. Tandaan nyo lang yung term na to. Of course, yung mga fast feathers natin, mas magiging shorter yung brooding period nila. Obviously. Okay? So, next. Ano ba to? Okay. So, listen to the chicks. Pakinggan nyo yung mga chicks nyo. Okay? Always listen to them. Because they are always, what? Right. Para hindi kayo i-left. Okay? Para hindi kayo iwan. So, ito yung pattern. I don't know if you can see it. But hopefully you can. So, example, this is your brooding cage. You would know if your lighting or if your artificial heat is too hot if yung distribution ng mga chicks is nasa perimeter ng inyong brooding cage. Tapos, merong little noise, may panting. Oh, panting. Ano yung panting? And then, yung wings nila, medyo extended. Okay? Yes, Gian? May gusto kang sabihin?
Ma'am, yung ilang chicks na kailangan na maglagay sa isang kurungan, di ba 100? Kung walang ilaw, nagkukuddle sila, di ba?
Nagkakuddle sila, Gian?
Like, hugging each other?
Yes, of course. 100 chicks. Wait. Yung ratio natin is 100 chicks per
square meter.
Square meter.
Per square meter, di ba?
Yep. So, obviously, if they are crowding or if they are forming in one area.
As a group,
yes, correct. May problem. Depende kung saan sila nag-form or nagkakadel. Let's say here, one example. If they are cuddling or if they're forming a group na malapit sa ating artificial heat, possible na it's too cold. Okay? Pero if nag-group sila na hindi sa artificial heat natin, possible na uneven yung temperature distribution or may something wrong sa environment mismo. Okay? So, sabi mo nga, if walang artificial heat na nilagay, okay? Yeah. So, nilalamig sila, yes, malaki yung chance na magkakadal among each other sila or mag, what do you call that? Yung nag, they tap one another.
Another.
I mean, yung nagtatangkas-tangkas sila.
Nag-grouping na lang.
Hindi ko alam yung Tagalog. Basta they stacking. Tend to mount. They tend to mount each other.
Stacking.
Pinatay ko yung electric fan kasi walang artificial heat dito. Ang lamig. Okay. So, ganon. Ganito yung mga indicators. Kung may something wrong sa paglagay mo ng lighting or sa artificial heat mo. Makikita nyo if evenly distributed lang sila sa yung brooding cage. So, it's just right. Sana ganun din sa love, no? If there's something wrong, merong mga indicators.
Meron, pag nagiging cold na siya sa'yo.
Oo. Oh. Pero sana, if cold na siya, lagyan mo lang ng artificial heat, magiging close ulit, magkakadal ulit. Kaso, it doesn't apply. Unlike sa manok.
Anong klaseng heat?
Standing heat. Joke lang. Okay. So, next. Growing. Tapos na tayo sa brooding, ah. So, si brooding, 0 to 4 weeks lang. And then, after 0 to 4 weeks or 0 to 6 weeks. Depende again sa practice ng farm. Pero generally, 0 to 6, okay? Maximum limit si 6 weeks. minimum limit si 4 weeks. Growing management, growers na, supplemental heat is no longer necessary. Hindi na kailangan ng artificial heat. Okay? So, very important factor sa growing management natin is that we need to monitor the body weight and of course, the uniformity in the flock. Why? Bakit kailangan nating i-monitor yung weight and uniformity? Because sa growers natin, yun na nga, growers could possibly be go in 3 directions, di ba? Meron tayong pwede yung growers maging broiler, pwedeng maging layers, and then pwede ipunta siya sa breeder. So, let's say broiler. Let's say yung ibobroiler natin or let's say imimit type natin. So, we really want to have a uniform sizes as much as possible sa iyong group. Walang masyadong nahuhuli sa size, walang masyadong nauuna sa size. Hopefully, sana the same yung weight because it's easier to be marketed, no? And then, sometimes kasi merong mga demand na kailangan is ganitong weight. And then, usually, bulk pa yung orders. Let's say, if a big commercial farm na for broilers, no? And then, again, babalik naman tayo dito sa growth is controlled for layers and breeders but not for broilers. Kaya tinatawag siyang maintenance phase. So if you will encounter a question na let's say what is the phase where you control the growth for layers and breeders but not broilers? Nan. That's the maintenance phase. Usually may question na ganyan. And again, bakit kinokontrol si layers yung bakit kinokontrol yung growth ni layers and the breeders? Because we don't want them to have a difficulty in producing eggs. Okay? And then, acceleration of body weight increases to attain sexual maturity with good body conformation. The negative drawback here would be yung body niya, parang sexually mature na, pero yung reproductive tract niya is not yet mature. Okay? Too young. So, the reproductive rate would be low. Or if sa mammals, the conception rate would be low. Ganon. So, sa ano naman, sa feed management naman natin for growers, we need to gradually increase feed allowance during preparation for lay. If layers, meron tayong ina-observe na restricted feeding. Ganon din. Yung term pwede rin maging controlled feeding. Okay? Talagang kinokontrol yung feeding natin sa layers because we don't want them to get too fat. The same principle sa diniscuss natin sa swine and sa small ruminants. If papunta ng farrowing or laying or parturition, we don't want them to get too fat. Floor space depends on the rearing system. Of course, depende na yon. Pero again, sa Peñalosa farm practice, if you can still remember, they really exhibit a kind of housing system sa layers na pinadidikit-dikit and mas gusto nila na much closer yung mga hens nila or mga layers nila because that farm specifically believes na nag-i-induce siya ng hormones na mas map-trigger yung egg production because of that stress. Again, they believe sa survival instinct ng isang animal na kailangan niya mag-reproduce. Peñalosa farms, they practice that. Mas nagdidikit-dikit. And then, light should not exceed 12 hours for layers. Light period will again be increased and maintained during the laying phase. So one cardinal rule sa ating light during growing period that we increase the light during laying period, but we don't increase the light during during growing period. If you can still remember, I will not explain it again na lang. Just go back sa ating discussion about pineal gland. Okay. Sa excretory system natin, if you can, endocrine pala. Sa ating endocrine system, okay, because yung pineal gland is our gland na responsible sa melatonin. Okay, related siya na magti-trigger ng egg production. Okay? So, because of the lighting, magiging stimuli siya sa pineal gland as well as secretion of melatonin. That's why mas ini-induce yung ovulation o yung egg production. Just go back for the full and depth explanation sa ating endocrine discussion. Okay? Light period. Photoperiodism natin will fall under the pineal gland. Melatonin. Laying management. After growers, yun lang naman kasimple. We go sa laying. So, feeds, dietary composition natin is called layer ration or breeder ration. So, if that specific chicken, let's say hen, is for layer production or for egg production, then layer ration, of course. And then, if you will use that specific chicken for breeding, then that's a breeder ration. Okay? So, chicken, gallimax, if you're aware. And they need to contain 15 to 18% protein level. And guys, remember, if layer ration siya, ano yung isang nutrient na very important or mineral? Anyone? If layer ration siya, ano? Anong mineral yung pinaka-important? Aside, of course, sa nutrient na protein, meron talagang isang mineral na mataas sa layer ration.
Calcium.
Correct. Calcium. Why? Why do we include?
For the bones po.
Okay.
And for the growth.
For the eggs.
Okay. Correct.
Eggshells.
Correct. 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 Correct din gyan yung sa bones. Kasi nga, diba, sa discussion natin last time, na because of the, what do you call this? Because of the demand ng egg na mataas yung calcium concentration sa eggshells, di ba? Merong chance na gagamitin ni hen yung mga calcium reserves niya sa kanyang bones. So in order for that to be avoided, we want to increase yung calcium present sa kanyang ration or sa kanyang feed. Okay? We are increasing the calcium sa feed niya para no need na ni hen i-consume yung mga calcium reserves niya na need niya din sa body niya para lang mag-produce ng egg. Okay? Because, let's say, if the ration is, the ration lacks calcium or kulang sa calcium, yung tendency is gagamitin ni hen yung calcium reserves niya from the bone. And yung result nun, or yung endpoint nun, magiging sufficient yung calcium sa eggshell. However, magiging brittle yung bones ni chicken. Yung tendency, mapipilay siya or magiging mahina siya. Okay?
Magiging deformities.
Correct. May deformities. Correct. Magiging mahina because mababawasan yung calcium sa bones, which is very vital, of course, sa bones natin or sa bones ng chicken. Next, just look out na lang if ano yung calcium requirement, ha? Sa review material. Try as much as possible, guys. I think pinost ko rin yun sa Google Classroom. Philippine National Standard na mga ano yung gamitin nyo. Na mga nutrient requirement, spacing requirement, meron tayong tinatawag na Philippine National Standard. Try to search about it and I think na-post ko rin yan sa Google Classroom. Water, of course, it needs to be ad libitum. 24 hours, it must be always available. And as a suggestion, dapat every day pinapalitan. Egg collection, one egg a day, but egg production occasionally skips days. But the usual flow is always one day per egg. Okay, so the production or the laying would be around 24 to 26 hours. Nangingitlog. And then oviposition normally happens around 7 a.m. to 4 p.m. And then the collection, usually pinapractice ng mga layer farms is around 12 noon. Okay? Egg collection per day. And then, yung group of eggs, ano yung tawag sa kanila? Group of eggs, ang tawag sa kanila is clutch. Okay, clutch. The same sa pawikan. Tawag din sa group of eggs sila clutch. Okay? So, kung sa baboy, liter size. Sa manok, clutch. So, systems of broiler operation. Meron tayong all-in, all-out. Sandara Park. In or out, galit. Yeah. All-in, all-out. Pinakasimple na system ng broiler operation, pagpasok ng lahat ng sisiyo, all at the same time, pag-harvest sa kanila, lalabas sila, all at the same time. That's it. Yan lang yung tandaan nyo. Single age, sabay-sabay silang papasok, the same age, sabay-sabay din silang lalabas. Yun yung all in, all out. Pinakasimple, pinakamadali na broiler operation, because isang age group lang yung mafo-focus mo, all the same age, and then mas madaling mag-sanitize and yung biosecurity is mas madaling i-handle because paglabas nila, pwede mo nang i-sanitize lahat. Wala nang maiiwan. Sanitize, sanitize, sanitize. And then pagpasok, of course, fully sanitized na, maganda yung biosecurity, papasok naman ulit. That's the all-in, all-out. Second, another operation for broiler is the two-stage operation. So, when we say two-stage operation, meron tayong dalawang age group, calls for separate brooder house and grower house. So, merong mga chicks and meron ng mga grower chickens. Okay? So, dalawang age group. Lastly, yung multiple stage broiler operation. Similar lang sa two stage, pero usually ginagamit na to ng mga malalaking broiler farms, malalaking farm operation, and similar, except that there should be more units to facilitate as many stages or accommodate various ages. The turnover of chicks can be either daily, every 2 weeks, weekly, bi-weekly. Ganon. Mas malaki. And the same lang sa two-stage, however, mas maraming units na fina-facilitate. And merong turnover every week or every day. Every 2 days, yes. Tandaan nyo lang guys, all in, all out, two stage, kag multiple stage. Simple lang naman tandaan. Here, I think if you've already reviewed animal science, no, merong mga question, especially from CLSU questionnaires, na mga Acres, Cobb, Starbrough, Indian River, Peterson, Pilch. So, ito yung mga strains na minamarket sa Philippines. Okay, and these strains are sourced out, okay, or locally sourced from these different companies or corporations or farm. Okay, so Arbor Acres, very, very popular na from San Miguel yan. Okay, San Miguel Corp. We all know naman yung San Miguel is mostly nga minomonopolize na nila yung Mindanao part for corn, diba? So, yung strain nila is Arbor Acres. And then Sarmiento Agricultural Development Corporation, isang sikat din to, yung Cobb strain. And then Universal Rubina Farms, may-ari ng Robinson, Starbrough, Indian River, Winmar Poultry Farms, RFM Corporation, Peterson. So if possible, try to take a screenshot because wala lang, para lang matandaan nyo. Familiarization, malay nyo, diba? Trivia question. And sa yes, mga CLSU question, talagang lumalabas to. Okay, so Avian, ay, may questions? I forgot to ask. Wala naman. Guys, are you still there? Feel free lang to raise your hands.
Dito pa po.
Okay. And then, avian female reproductive systems natin, paano ba mag-work or paano ba mag-oviposition yung or paano ba mag-lay yung ating hen? So, ovary first. Ito yung involve. Dito na produce yung ovum. Okay? Or yung egg. And then, infundibulum receives the yolk from ovary where sperm is stored and fertilization takes place 15 minutes. Oh, 15 minutes? Grabe. Bilis? Baka iba yung iniisip nyo, ah. Okay. Infundibulum. And then, after that, yung magnum secretes the thick white of the eggs. 3 hours. Grabe! Yung fertilization, 15 minutes lang. Pero yung secretion ng puti, 3 hours. Oh my gosh. Okay. And then, isthmus, shell membranes are placed around the yolk and thick white. 1 1/4 hours, 1.25 hours. And then yung shell gland, thin white outer shell, added with the egg, 20 hours. And then lastly, the vagina completed egg is stored for a short time until laid, 25 to 27 hours. Actually, 24 yan. One day lang usually yung ano. Guys, this is self-sikap na lang. Sariling sikap. Try as much as possible to remember the process. Let's say, saan si shell gland na form, ilang oras si shell gland na form, saan yung fertilization nangyayari. Okay? Sino si magnum, saan si yolk na form, ganon. Ano si yolk? Hindi ko makakalimutan, isang question sa board exam last 2019 is that, sa animal science, ano yung vitamins or ano yung nutrient, parenthesis, vitamins or minerals, okay, na hindi makikita sa egg? Yung choices is, I'm confused between, I think, ascorbic acid. Gian, do you remember?
Ano yung question?
Ano yung specific nutrient or vitamins or minerals na hindi makikita sa egg?
Hindi makikita sa egg. Parang quant yun eh. Kalimutan ko.
Shit. Hindi ko na ma-remember. Pero may isang kasama si ascorbic acid na
pinag-iisipan. Basta E yun eh. E-sulin, E-scubin. Basta yan. Basta E. E. Basta E-something.
Lain nga iara sa mind ko yan. Basta. Ah, ano nga yung, ano, yung mineral, ah, yung mineral na common sa milk?
Milk, calcium.
Calcium.
Wait. Nakalimutan ko.
Here, yeah, I think it's calcium. Yung question, guys, ano yung mineral or vitamins na hindi makikita sa egg yolk? So, four choices, di ba? Dalawa doon, alam ko na sure ako na makikita sa yolk. So, eliminate two. I'm torn between ascorbic acid and then calcium. So kayo, what do you think the answer is? Egg yolk yung pinag-uusapan ha, hindi egg.
Calcium.
Yung hindi makikita sa egg yolk?
Yeah. Para sa ako na ha.
Oh.
As in, guessing.
One of the questions na talagang like, as in depressing after board exam na feeling ko very confused ko, like among all questions yung goat tsaka ganit yung itong question yung pinaka nahirapan ko until now. Actually sabi nila yung answer of course is ascorbic acid, pero hindi ko na talaga binalikan yung question ng as in. I really felt bad that time. So, ganun. Share ko lang. Share ko lang isang experience. So, that's why, analysis. Because yung ascorbic acid is really, ano, for citrus.
Citrus. Nakalimutan ko na. Binahaw ko.
I don't know. Pero try nyo, guys. Search ko anong answer. Pero it's between calcium and ascorbic acid. And then, share ko lang. Ganun lang. May mga dilemma sa board exam para makarelate kayo if kayo na yung kukuha. Minsan talaga, magpapadisappoint lang sa inyo. Hindi buong exam eh. Mga isang, dalawa, tatlong questions lang. So, ganon. Next, hatchery operations natin. When we say hatchery operation, yun na yung ano, incubation and then maghahatch na siya. So storage, the physiological zero of an egg is 21 degrees Celsius. So when we say physiological zero, it is the point where it's felt, no, by the skin or by the egg, that it's neither warm or neither cold. It's under ordinary condition lang. It's 21 degrees Celsius that will put the egg on a pause. Okay, i-store natin siya. If nasa 21 degrees Celsius pala, I mean, this is the normal temperature. Okay, under normal condition. Normal condition. Na yung mga metabolic processes will continue. Okay? That's what we need to remember. Nasa normal condition and the metabolic processes or the development of an embryo will continue. So if we want to store the egg, we need to go down to the physiological zero. Since the physiological zero is at 21 degrees Celsius, where the development or the metabolism will continue. If we want to store the egg, we need to go down. Hence, if we store the egg, the temperature must be around 15 to 18. Okay? At this temperature, the development or the metabolic processes of an embryo, okay, sa egg will pause. And the relative humidity should also be 75%. Okay? And then, the storage must not be more than 7 days. Okay? So, that's the reason why. That's the reason why we put yung mga eggs, di ba, para hindi ma-spoil. Let's say, for example, sa spoilage ng ating mga table eggs, we put them sa loob ng refrigerator. To prevent spoilage. Nagpo-pause yung mga metabolism sa loob or development sa loob. And then, what else? Example, sa isang hatchery operation, wala pang available na incubators. Because maraming eggs and then limited lang yung number of incubators mo, that's why we store them. And we need to make sure na yung storage nila is may mga ganitong conditions. Okay? Physiological zero is the normal condition na magkukontinue yung development nila or yung metabolic processes nila. And if we want to stop the development, to give a pause to the egg, we need to lower the 21 degrees Celsius. That's the explanation why we put it on a ref or in a chiller. So, hatching of eggs. Meron tayong natural and artificial na incubation or what they call this process or way. Natural is, of course, usage of brooder hen or duck. However, this will have the hen lay one egg per day for a period of several days. And then after 21 days of incubation or sitting, the eggs will, of course, hatch. However, this is very not applicable when we say it's a big commercial farm. Okay, or it's a big farm for egg production. This process will be not feasible, will not be this is time consuming, and this will be hard. And of course, you would need a number of brooder hens. So that's the reason why, because of those disadvantages, we came to the point na meron na tayong mga artificial incubators. Like, ganito. And then, of course, incubator keeps the eggs at a proper temperature and humidity. Ito na yung mga temperature requirements sa isang incubator, humidity. And remember, guys, if yung eggs nasa loob na ng incubator, it still needs to be turned 3 to 5 times daily. So, meron ng actually mga advanced incubators na may movement na sa loob or mechanical induced, okay? May turning na mismo sa loob ng incubator, pero meron namang ibang incubators na mga hindi pa masyadong advanced na manually pa rin yung turning. So, meaning yung technician pa rin o yung racer pa rin yung nagma-manually turn.
Nagtitilt okay? Po.
Nagtitilt. Oh, yes.
Left and right niya, ganito. Direction.
Why we are turning the eggs or why we are tilting the eggs? Because to prevent the embryo to stick sa may shell membrane. Or for example, itlog to. Hindi natin gusto na yung embryo nandito. Gusto natin ma-maintain na nasa middle. Okay, that's why turning is important. Because if steady lang sa, imagine nyo, for the good 21 days, steady lang, walang movement, may tendency na bababa yung embryo and magdidikit siya sa membrane ng shell. Okay? Gets, guys? Kaya pa. Dali na lang. Selection of hatching eggs. So, sa isang egg, we look at the exterior and the interior quality. In exterior, of course, cleanliness ng shell. Okay, walang organic matter, walang mga dirty debris, walang bakas. we prefer those, especially yung mga marketed eggs, no? And then yung shape, not round or oblong. Gusto natin matulis yung end. That's what we want. I don't know how to draw it. Basta prefer na, mangga ba to, charot? Basta prefer is merong pointy end yung egg. That's a good exterior quality. Soundness, no cracks. Of course, hindi natin gusto na may crack yung itlog niya. Ah, niya? Hindi niya. Nang itlog pala. And then, size, hindi naman masyadong maliit unless yung pinag-uusapan nyo quail eggs, or hindi naman extremely large unless pinag-uusapan nyo ostrich eggs. Okay? Interior quality naman, of course, yung air cell, the viscosity, yung viscosity ng albumen or ng white part, and then yung abnormalities, mayroong mga blood spot, may cracks, may leaks. So, usually to know the quality ng interior part ng egg, we use candling, the candling method. So, ano ba yung candling? This is done to test the egg fertility and viability by placing the egg against a bright light. So, simple lang. Yung mga hasana talaga sa incubating eggs or sa mga poultry raisers and nag-use ng incubators, usually hasang-hasana sila sa candling. And the outline of the contents will be seen from the outside. Itutok mo lang sa light nyo. Or sa fluorescent. Yes, pwede. Kahit ano lang. As long as makikita mo yung internal contents niya. So, ano ba yung mga eggs? Ano ba yung mga eggs na minamarket natin? Table eggs. Eggs galing sa manok or eggs galing sa duck na ginagamit natin sa pagluto. Okay? Hatching eggs. Hatching eggs naman yung mga eggs na ino-incubate natin para maging chicks. Okay? Chicks, manok, or pwede rin sa ducklings. Another type of egg is yung balot sa puti. Yung in-incubate, good for 17 to 18 days. Sino may idea dito kung ano yung balot? Or paano yung mechanism ng balot? Or paano nagagawa yung balot? Okay. Walay. Yan.
Po, nalaman ko po nakabalot din kami. Yung egg, kuhain mo na ng 17 days or 18 days. Kunin mo na ng... Kita mo yung sa natural, kunin mo yan. Pagkuha mo, magluto yan, ilagay mo sa mainit, i-boil mo.
Okay.
Boil or ikan mo.
Okay, good. Good. Actually, that's it. So, yung balot, usually yung incubation period ng duck yung ginagamit for balot eh. Yung duck is around 28 days. So, around 17 to 18 days, no, hindi natin pinapa-complete yung incubation period niya. Hina-harvest na natin yon and then binuboil. Tama, sige yan. Yun yung balot. Pero, if hinayaan mong, for example, ma-incubate up to more than 18 days or up to 28 days, mag-hatch yun. But since pinutol mo na yung incubation, hindi na mag-hatch yun. That's the balot. Okay? Meron tayong actually dalawang kinds of balot. Meron tayong balot sa puti and then balot sa mamatong. Yung balot sa puti, yung incubated sa 17 to 18 days and yung mamatong, 14 to 16 days. And then related din dito yung malaki or yung maliit lang yung sisiyo. Alam ng mga mangbabalot yon kasi they practice candling na. Yung Pinoy, incubated infertile ducks, infertile ducks. I'm sorry. Infertile duck eggs or egg with dead embryo. Okay? Infertile. Pinoy na tuyo or Pinoy na may sabaw or hihigupin? Bah! Gusto niyo yarn? Hihigupin? Next is the century egg. Ito yung sabi ko sa inyo kanina. This is also century egg, pwedeng maging duck eggs. Yung black, coated with rice hull and mud, with the white of the egg having gelatinous texture and grayish translucent color. Yes, yung kung try nyo search later, I don't have any picture here kasi yung century egg is black and then meron siyang jelly or gelatinous appearance. Okay.
Yes.
I think this is very common in Korea, no? And in Chinese part.
Yes, ma'am. Really, sa mga Chinese nga pagkaon.
Yes, yes. They really like, or they really are fan of century eggs.
To 100 days siya nga nakaka-coat. Bala, ma'am, na nga siya century egg, tawag siya. Mm,
hence the century.
Yeah.
The white of the egg. Chick sexing. Ito yung mga last part na lang ng poultry production, other managements natin. Chick sexing is very important in poultry production because as early as possible, especially if you are for breeding and if you are for laying, we want to separate the male and the female. Because as early as possible, again, sabi ko nga, yung mga male, need na natin i-call out. Okay? Para hindi na tayo mag-waste ng feed or hindi na tayo maglagay ng additional cost or hindi na natin papalakihin yan kasi hindi naman siya, wala naman siyang silbi or wala naman siyang purpose sa isang laying farm. That's why it's very important to have chick sexing as early as we can. Okay? So, yung mga layer farms, if na-observe nyo nga, mahilig sila yung mga day-old chicks. If malapit yung isang street food, di ba, meron mga day-old chicks. Kinukuha nila yon sa mga layer farms na male. Okay, na lalaki yon yung kinakal out. Auto-sexing based on sex-linked traits. Meron kasing mga breeds, okay, or strain ng chickens or chicks na nag-exhibit ng mga sex-linked traits. Especially if aware na sila sa genetic composition ng parental lines. Let's say, for example, this is just hypothetical, no? One example lang sa sex-linked traits is that the appearance of a stripe line sa isang chick, automatic, they assume na lalaki yon. Because nga meron mga sex-linked traits. Yung mga stripe color, or sometimes merong chicks na brown, merong chick na yellow, that can also be a sex-linked trait. Okay? Isa yun sa mga example. Vent sexing naman is that they look at the vent, okay? And then, there's a present of a rudimentary male organ na medyo nagproprotrude. Okay? Like the genitalia of the male chick. Mamaya may picture ako dito. However, vent sexing is very demanding when it comes naman sa expertise. Okay? Demanding when it comes sa expertise. Dapat experience ka na masyado dito. Tingnan mo yung sapwetan niya part. And then feather sexing. This is the very common, okay? Based on feather characteristics, when a fast feathering male is crossed by a slow feathering female, not applicable to all chicks. Not applicable, guys, ha, to all breeds, but we have cases na ganito. Usually, if one-step curve shape-winged siya, male yon, and if two-curve, female yon. So, if straight lang, male, okay? So, if dalawang ganito, female. So, guys, I hope you will not forget this. Okay? tangan nila.
Noted.
And then, try to review. Meron kasing mga small, may mga covert term. Like for example, sa female, you can zoom in this one. Meron siyang long, ganon. Usually, female yan. And then, yung male, same size lang. Okay? Sa feather. Feather to guys, ah, this is just an example. Hindi to yung dragon feet chicken. Pero feather to, let's say lang. This is male. And ito yung female. Pero again, yung sexing really requires experience. Sometimes kasi hindi naman masyado visible yung difference ng smaller span ng wing nila. And hindi naman visible yung may curve. So, it really requires expertise. Basta ganun. Vent sexing. This is an example of vent sexing naman. So, if makikita nyo sa male, medyo, here oh, merong may nagpo-protrude. And sa female, wala. But again, this is not always the case. Okay? Depende sa breed and depende as well sa nag-vent sexing. Okay? But those are the example. Other management, vaccination natin. So, last time, tinanong ko kayo kung anong difference ni immunization. Na-discuss natin anong difference ni immunization tsaka ni vaccination. Immunization is the process where our body is already immune, or is the process of our body being immune sa specific virus na yan, okay? Or sa specific na disease na yan. So vaccination is the process where we are provided by the immunity, okay? Vaccination is the process which we are provided sa immunity na yan. So, we have different modes of administration ng vaccine, okay? So, intranasal, yung parang eye mo, dinadrop instead sa mata, sa ilong. Yes.
Uh-uh.
Okay? I think B1. I'm not sure, ha? Pero yung blue. Sa intranasal. Baka may magtanong, meron bang nose yung manok or yung chick?
Sa beak. Sa bubbles ng beak.
Ah, correct. Sa itaas part ng beak. Intranasal. Intraocular. Ito, parang eye mo talaga. Dinadrop lang sa eyes part. And then web wing. Ano yung web wing? Stab method. Mm-hmm. Ano yung web wing? Kala ko sasagot ka yan.
Hindi ko alam.
Yung web wing is nasa wing part.
Yes.
Just beneath the wing. Okay? Sinastab, okay. Ini-inject. And then, yung ating mass vaccination, usually sa mass vax, tawag nila.
Na-remember ko na.
Yung, I think, ginawa natin sa
Negros. Negros.
That's a web wing. Spray. Mass vaccination is spray. Yes. Vaccine can also be sprayed. Okay? Intramuscular injection sa muscle. Usually, this is injected sa thigh part. Okay? Sa thigh part. Thigh. And then, subcutaneous natin, this is injected, you will not go deeper sa muscle. It's just beneath the skin. Okay? That's how you inject if subcutaneous yung administration. Okay? Mafe-feel mo naman, di ba, sa chicken, like, the skin is very obvious naman if nasa skin ka na, or it's very obvious naman once you inject if mag-go into the muscle ka na. So, merong intramuscular and meron namang subcutaneous. Another practice, no, sa chicken, I'm not sure if everyone is aware na meron ding artificial insemination sa chicken. Hindi lang to para sa ating mga four-legged animals. So, here's how you collect the semen sa chicken. It's not the semen actually, it's the sperm cell. I don't know if everyone is aware na nagko-collect tayo or nagpo-perform tayo ng artificial insemination sa ating poultry species. This is, I'm not sure lang if this is greatly, if where is the specific area here in the Philippines na nagpa-practice ng artificial insemination sa country. Sa mga sa mga institution, okay, na into poultry breeding. Pero, in outside the country, pinapractice na to, especially in Turkish. Since mataas, example, sa USA, mataas yung demand ng Turkish nila. Para makasustain sila ng supply, or so that they can meet the demand of their people, they use artificial insemination since it is very efficient. Okay? So, look, pay attention to this. Nakikita nyo ba yung white? That's actually the sperm cell already. Since, guys, walang accessory organs yung chicken. It's the genetic tract of the male chicken or of the rooster, let's say, or the male avian species is very simple. Wala silang accessory glands, hence, wala rin silang semen. So basically, yung lumalabas sa kanila is concentrated sperm ito. Unlike sa mammals or unlike sa human, merong semen. May part lang doon na sperm cell. Okay? Sa kanila, puro sperm cell. This is already a billions of sperm cell, yung puti na to. Okay? And then, what else? A maximum na mas papalabas ni male avian is 3 ml. Okay? And that 3 ml again is a billion of sperm cells na. It's very, very concentrated. And paano po yung if may magtatanong, paano po mai-induce yung ejection or paglabas ng sperm cell sa male since wala silang very obvious na penis or wala silang external genitalia? So, yung ginagawa is tinitrigger yung paglabas ng sperm cell. Ginagawa lang ng mga nagpapalabas noon is minamassage. Okay? Yung sensation ng massage sa may vent part or sa may cloaca part ng isang male, that will already arouse the male avian. Okay? Hence, lalabas na siya ng sperm cell na concentrated. So, after lumabas ng sperm cell and after makolect nun, gaya ganito, dinidilute yon. Merong dilution na nangyayari. Dinidilute yon sa isang solution. Dinidilute yon sa isang solution. And then, I think Ringer solution yung tawag dun. Yes. I'm not sure sa solution kung ano yon. Basta, merong chemical or merong solution na dinidilute yon and then it's ready for insemination. It needs dilution, okay, or it needs to be mixed sa another liquid because if not, the sperm would be very concentrated. Okay? So, maraming hens ang magbe-benefit sa ganitong kaliit na sperm cell. Okay? Malaki na yung 3 ml, guys, sa chicken. So, next vaccination. Ito just memorize because sa 2019 LEA, merong lumabas na ganito. Like, yung question is, ano yung vaccine or ano yung medication na, NCD, let's say, yung lumabas sa board exam last 2019 is anong route ng administration ina-apply yung Newcastle's disease medication or yung vaccine for your Newcastle's disease. So, yung nasa choices, it could be intranasal, ocular, ringweb, that's why. Pero ito lang naman yung common. Ito yung naman yung common. Just try as much as possible yung apat na to. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yung apat na to or yung lima na to is ma-memorize yung kung ano yung route. Okay? Ito na yung pinaka-common. So, lastly, guys, this will be the last slide. Hindi ko na in-include yung feeding because, again, this is all sariling sikap. Memorize nyo yung percent CP per type and per age. Or try to familiarize if not memorize. Okay. So, that's it for tonight. Too much. How are you?
Approved.
So, thank you again. So, if may question, please ask. If wala, ask lang Japon. Ano may mga questions ka mo? Wala naman? Okay. Walang question. So, I think that's it. Sure ka mo, wala ka mo question? Diyos ko. So, ano man. I'll just chat if when the next meeting will be. Because, actually, nag-exceed na ta sa 40 hours. Pero, as much as possible, abi, I want to tackle all the discussion. Kay sayang man. May extra time malang. Like, 3 hours na malang bilin. And then, your animal diseases, your computation, and your nutrition will be discussed by like, I think, mga September 1. Okay, so, nag-exceed na gin man sa 40 hours, pero we will finish the animal science. So, tentative schedule, guys. Please take note sa mga present and sa mga tanaw recording. Post-test in animal science will be given on September 2 to 4. Okay? 2 to 4. Because September 1 yung discussion ni Laika for ano, solvings nyo and diseases. Okay? 2 to 4. I'll just chat sa group chat if when pwede masalot ang cattle. Because cattle na lang yung last sa akin. Okay?